That going, start recording. What's up, y'all? Opex here. Today we got a game between Grubby as the orc and Sinfinite as human taking place on Twisted Meadows. Let's speed it up a little bit so we can get things going underway. Fog of War. Now there isn't a altar right here, meaning that he's got to be going for a tavern hero or something of that nature. His opponent over here, Sinfinite, may be opening up with a standard Archmage, and so he is. And yes, it's definitely going to be a tavern hero. Let's see what's going to happen here. So it's a grunt going up north. He's probably going to spot his human opponent over here. Peasant, peon, going after the tavern. Let's see what he picks up. See what kind of game we're going to get going here. Archmage is going to try to fast creep. I'm not sure if this grunt's going to delay that at all. And of course it is. He's not pulling militia yet. Very strange. Might be pulling him now. Let's see what tavern hero. It is a Fire Lord. And with the Fire Lord, strange strategy coming here from Grubby. But I would expect no different from Grubby. Grunt still delaying the Archmage from creeping, and there is a Lava Spawn. With the Lava Spawn and the Fire Lord going straight after the Archmage, doing a little bit of damage, now going after the Footman. There is a Water Elemental being spawned, doing as much damage on that Lava Spawn as much as possible. Archmage backing off a little bit. And this is definitely delaying the creeping of the human if he's not getting experience out of this. I'm going after that Lava Spawn, trying to get some experience, it looks like, and to keep it from continually spawning more. Fire Lord taking a bit of damage, but so was that Archmage. Another Lava Spawn being spawned here. Fire Lord's out of mana. Taking a lot of damage on that Fire Lord, like I was saying. But did get the Water Elemental, which is 42 experience. And then the Archmage just got about 42 experience as well from that Lava Spawn. Not sure who's winning out on these engagements. I believe the Orc is definitely doing a little bit better here because it stopped the human from creeping. Grunt over here taking a bit of damage for no reason. Shop being built. And it looks like the Fire Lord is now regenerating hit points and mana. Still trying to continue a little bit of a push here, making sure that human does not creep. I'm not sure what kind of units he's trying to get. Grubby is halfway to tier 2. A little bit less on the human, but that's pretty much standard. But without militia creeping anything, the Archmage is rather low on experience for this state of the game. Stage. It is going to be a tower. I'm wondering if he is going to up it. He should up at any time now, and he should get that shop going. Oh, here's the healing. Archmage taking more damage here. More damage and more damage. The Archmage is in a rather picky, a little bit of a pickle here. One more hit, and he will go down. Oh, but he hit the Footman instead. Oh, but there's the Lava Spawns. Look at these Lava Spawns. How did I miss that? The Lava Spawns went over here to creep out the green camp. And now the Fire Lord's sitting on much more experience, and I doubt the Archmage of Sinfinite was figuring that there was going to be four Lava Spawns waiting for him around that corner. Forced to revive him from the altar. Of course, level 1 doesn't take long. But it looks to me like he's in a rather rough situation here. Fire Lord, that is level 2 now. Going after that tower, making sure that tower doesn't go up. However, there is a lot of healing going down, and I believe that tower should go up at the cost of perhaps a couple workers. Archmage now out. Is he going to get a surround on any units here? No. Not focusing the tower with the Fire Lord, and I don't think he could have anyways. I believe this will be a TP town portal. Oh, I thought he was going to let him die. Gets another worker here. again, no experience on the Archmage here, and level 2 on the Fire Lord, so of course the Orc is doing a great job here. Grubby's known for his skill, but there is a Fire Lord of Sinfinite. So now, it's Fire Lord versus Fire Lord in this matchup. Grunt getting healed up. Fire Lord, Archmage, bunch of footmen going after the base of Grubby, hoping to stop some tier 2 units and or buildings. But this is double barracks here. Very strange. It is a catapult and berserker strength. Without the tier 2 buildings to cancel, he will focus down these burrows. Should be a water elemental dropping here again anytime now. The orc workers are definitely not going to be able to stop this from going down. Perhaps able to keep this up because they are surrounded the burrow, making the footmen that much more difficult to come over here and attack it. Fire Lord coming in at the human base, going after that tower. Of course, he's trying to heal the tower, but I do believe this tower will go down because, again, that surround on the tower makes the workers not be able to attack it very well. However, he did lose all his mana in that engagement, but he does have a clarity potion. Catapult, trying to attack these footmen, and I believe it's doing a decent amount of damage, but it's not enough. Loses three burrows, I believe. 1, 2, and I think 3. And about to lose his last burrow here. And at what cost here? I mean, Grubby killed all of his workers. Well, a big chunk of his workers. Close to level 3 now on that Fire Lord. Catapult doing some damage here. Again, I don't believe Catapults was the right unit here, but of course, it's always fun to watch. Fire Lord of Infinite taking a bunch of damage from the Fire Lord of Grubby. And looks like Grubby's forced to back off here, but keeping the grunts in the base to try to take down the rest of the workers here, trying to make this a fast, quick game. I hear lava spawns. Okay, so Sinfinite's lava spawns are now duplicating. So the grunts need to back off, and wow. I can't believe he just saved all 4 grunts against this army. This army should have definitely at least started focusing down grunts a little bit better, or Grubby's micro is just that much awesome. Going after the Scroll of Regens. Of course, he should be healing up his grunts. I mean, he has double here, but of course he's macroing and making sure that he can start producing units again. Now, of course, the human did not lose any farms to my knowledge, so he does have a bunch of supply. He is not blocked right now, but he will need some farms here momentarily, but there is Arcane Sanctum going up, so it is tier 2. Now, Grunts and Catapults and Fire Lord. This is very strange to watch, and I really hope that you're finding this entertaining. Lots of footmen here in this matchup. Footmen able to defend against those lava spawns. Very, very smart unit to continue to produce, especially before tier 2, which you are getting a bunch of Arcane Sanctum. Perhaps priests, sorceress, that kind of thing. It looks like Grubby's trying to play a micro game here. Trying to kite, find a good position, and then just, wow. Yeah, that's exactly what he's trying to do. Kind of turn back and aim for those footmen, doing a lot of damage on those footmen, surprisingly. But does end up doing a lot of damage to his own units as well. It's what happens when you attack ground. Focusing down the Fire Lord of Sinfinite, and I believe Sinfinite's Fire Lord can't really do much. But this catapult will go down to 1 catapult. I'm not sure if 1 catapult is enough DPS to take down all those footmen. So, lava spawn from Grubby is now duplicating. And that was a level 2, so it's 21 to 45 damage. A lot more than it was before. Grubby's Fire Lord is going ham on Sinfinite's Fire Lord right here. Focusing him down, making him, I believe he purchased a potion. Going after the footman now. Of course, defend doesn't work against the hero, but it definitely does a lot against the spawns here. Looks like he's focusing down the level 1 Archmage, and that's what I just said. He's still a level 1 Archmage. Okay, it's 2-2 now versus 3. Going after that Archmage, Catapult does go down by the hands of the Water Elemental. And Grubby's trying to come back in here to cancel something or kill workers or... I'm not sure, but I do know that the more that this Fire Lord attacks that footman, I believe he does more damage because he has that one thing on. What is it called? I'm not sure. But I believe you do like one more damage every time. One, then two more damage, then four more damage, then eight. It basically doubles. But he has that turned on. And it does about 6 mana per attack in terms of what it costs. Level 1 Lava Spawn still going after the hero here of Grubby. Human trying to stay safe. It looks like he's definitely massing his priests and his casters. Trying to finish off his second arcane. Perhaps might want another farm. Catapult. Definitely going down here. I don't see how this catapult can survive. Okay, now I do. Alright, so we got Grubby Spire Lord, almost a level 4, and that definitely spells disaster. The stronger that Fire Lord gets, the stronger those summon spawns get, the stronger he deals, the more damage he deals per attack. Because he definitely has that right-click ability. On. Oh, he has it turned off now. Level 4. Archmage trying to get to level 3. Fire Lord of Sinfinite also trying to get to level 3. Ring of Protection, not the best item. However, there is still no two. Okay, so we got a Spirit Lodge. Spirit Lodge able to train up walkers or what have you. I'm not exactly sure. Okay, I seen this. This game yesterday, so I know what he's actually going for. I'm not trying to be so clueless, but I'm trying. But this is a lot of damage that this Fire Lord's being having to take right here. I hope he doesn't lose his Fire Lord. Taking as much as he can, and then perhaps healing up. See what items he gets. He's getting that much closer to level 5. That's a lot of experience to have at tier 2. A tier 2 Fire Lord, mind you, with headhunters. Okay, so here we go with the engagement. We have level 2 still, but see what he's trying to do. He's trying to cancel the shop. Get the shop out of the game. And it is going to be a shaman. Shaman quickly purges the... What was that? A lava spawn? And now level 5 on Grubby's Fire Lord. Grubby's still continuing to engage here. He's definitely not able to do much damage against defended footmen. I believe that shouldn't be the target unit here in this scenario. However, headhunters definitely aren't the go-to unit as orc against human. Shaman, very good to dispel using his purge. And with that, he's definitely getting even more experience. He's almost halfway to 6 already. However, the Archmage and Fire Lord are almost 3-3, and if that happens, that can spell a lot of disaster for the Orc Grubby. Losing more units, level 3 on the Fire Lord of Sinfinite. Again, I'm not entirely sure what Grubby's thinking here. I think he's thinking, let's have a fun game. And that's what we're definitely seeing here. Spellbreaker, Heroes of the Human, going straight after that shop again. The orc definitely losing a lot of resources, not to mention his workers. Needs to really be careful here. He has no towers. He really doesn't have much to defend here. The catapult doing a decent amount of damage, but not very much. Should be focusing those casters where it could definitely do a lot more damage, and that's what I'm talking about. If it was focusing the casters, those casters can go down rather easily. Sorceresses might go down, but at what cost? A lot of peasants went down. Another headhunter pops back into action. Grunt. Wow. Grubby's almost level 6. I'm not sure if the ultimate's going to come in handy, but it is 3-3 on the human heroes. And looks like Grubby's able to defend this. Level 6 on the Fire Lord, going after that Spellbreaker, trying to get that kill and back off a little bit, and yes, he will do so. Getting a 215 gold unit right out of the equation. As many times as you can make that happen, the better. They're both still sitting on one base, and it looks like it's 34 supply to 49. So the human definitely has the advantage in the upcoming next few fights. But we'll see what's going to happen here. Grubby back up to full hit points. Got his units out. Still not quite sure what he's going. He's still getting a few headhunters. Not sure if that's the unit compilation that he needs. He has a catapult still back in base. Human going after another camp, trying to get higher up levels. Perhaps even expand at some point or opening up an expansion. Ring of Regeneration, not the most useful item in this matchup, but it might save him from a soul burn or something like that. Reduce damage taken. Great lightning shield over here, going after the workers. Workers immediately have to get out of there. They can't stick around in that kind of environment. That's for damn sure. Human back into play, and Grubby knows, hey, I need a better position here. Maybe I can snipe some units if they come too close. And that's looking exactly what he's doing. But to this amount of units right here, that's a lot of units. I'm not sure if Grubby can engage, or at least have a successful engagement. Lava Spawn now duplicating, but at what cost? Because there is the spell out, and it's giving the human even more experience. Grubby coming back into play, trying to take down some units whenever possible. And it looks like a TP right on top of Grubby's Shaman here. One Shaman does go down, but definitely has to force Grubby into a teleport. Sinfinite looking good right here, but it's still anyone's game in terms of what's going to happen in the future here. We know the skill of Grubby. He doesn't just back down real quick. This definitely seeming like a fun game to watch, and it's a fun game to cast, I'm not going to lie. You don't really see these units, or the heroes, or definitely the units from Grubby in this matchup. You don't see that usually in Orc vs. Human. Maybe a Fire Lord from the Human, but Fire Lord from the Orc, and Headhunters and Shaman, you don't see that. I mean, you're seeing it now, but that's not something you usually see. Another creep camp coming from the human player. Definitely going to get perhaps level 4 on both of his heroes. Should get level 4 on both of his heroes. So double level up, potion of invulnerability. And does Grubby bring a peon down here? Does he want to expand? Not quite sure, but he is putting a tower in his base. He knows how useful that's going to be. Lava Spawn tanking the damage here so we can minimize the use of healing cells. Here comes the human for another engagement. Double level up means let's keep fighting the orc here. Obviously the Fire Lord cannot increase his level with creeps. There's a lot of berserkers here. Getting focused down one of them. And I'm not entirely sure what the use of these headhunters here are. I mean, they could do a lot of damage if used properly, used on the casters. Definitely switched the very good micro by someone. I don't know who's altering the positioning of that fight right there, but it definitely worked in favor of Grubby being able to get inside to those casters. Spellbreakers. definitely the frontline unit of the human army, taking down another headhunter, berserker, going after the shop, making sure that shop doesn't go up. What's that? Three shaman over here off in the corner, not able to purge the summons. Even though there isn't any summons at the moment, doesn't mean that they aren't coming any second now. He definitely has the mana for it, but it looks like he's using his resources on getting up a slow expansion, meaning less units coming his way, but at this point he doesn't need many more units, and expansion definitely will come into play for Sinfinite. Grubby healing up, it looks like, and trying to find a better position here. He is safe-ish behind the big buildings here, like the main and the barracks. Does he have... He has a couple shaman over here, so he could purge. Okay, that catapult shouldn't be that far in front. Could easily be focused here. Alright, much better position. The human army looks like it needs to take down that barracks if it wants to continue this push, or it'll just stick around and not really do much. Now the human's baiting Grubby out of his base a little bit, and I think that was definitely the right decision, but it looks like a good battle here. Not many units are going down, but another berserker looks like it's going to go down, and another one. So definitely the human's making out better in this scenario. Purging more units here, or summons, level 7 on the Fire Lord, and he does have a tiny Great Hall, so he definitely knows he needs to expand. And human's backing off a little bit. Is this Grubby's time? It looks like it is. He's just going to go expand. Take some peons with him. And he's going to lose a Troll Berserker over this, and perhaps another peon. Actually, he does not lose the Troll Berserker. Manages to get away. Why the human isn't going after that expansion attempt from Grubby is beyond me. Not sure what his sight was, if he could see what he was doing, but or even if he clicked on his hero to know if, hey, he has a tiny Great Hall, what's he trying to do with that? And then he comes back without one. You know, all you have to do is click on the hero. Probably didn't do that. But if he takes down this barracks, there's little or no opposition to get in here. Definitely, if the human's trying to stay over here, that's good for Grubby still. But if the human was trying to get in over here, then there's not much room for Grubby to run. He can definitely corner in a bunch of units. Peons coming back. Oh, that's a big misplay from Grubby. Sinfinite still trying to hold on, thinking that, hey, my expansion is going to get up at any second now, and I can go in for the kill now. Grubby's missing bases. He doesn't have that much supply. I mean, yes, he does, but not enough to beat a human army like this. But there is still this engagement. Like I said, this is the better area for the human, if he can corner him in. But Grubby's definitely still able to hold this for the moment. But he is losing units. Few units here and there for both players, but I definitely believe Grubby's in a worse position. Sinfinite keeps throwing in these water elementals, but gets purged before taking down the shaman. 4.5 for both of the human heroes, while almost 8 for the Fire Lord of Grubby. Expansion is now up for Grubby. He is mining off of it. Going after the altar, not sure exactly why the altar is so important to him. I think it's because he wants to get to those burrows and those peons. One peon not going to be able to repair all that. So now it looks like he's just staying on the outside, just focusing on the main here, which I'm not sure if that's the best idea. I mean, Grubby's attacking him while he's not getting attacked. There is a shop over here, which is a very smart idea from the human. He can heal up, he can get clarities, bunch of options that plays this much more safer for the human. While the orc is just sort of cornered, just hoping that his expansion starts paying off and he can perhaps get better units, or maybe even See, he's not even getting any better units or anything like that. I believe he's just trying to keep this unit count here. Just to try to find a way to stop him from coming in. Kind of like spook him off. I think that's kind of his idea here. Get in here so my tower's gonna hit you and my catapult. And then try to take down one unit at a time while it retreats. Which is, not sure exactly why the human's playing into that, but... Sinfinite is definitely playing into Grubby's game here. Grubby has a shop. He's definitely going to get a bunch more clarities and healing salves. But he definitely sees the human expansion here. He definitely threw a peon over here. He knows what he's going up against. Me personally, if I was in Grubby's situation, I would have left right now. Oh, he has an expansion. I had a chance if he didn't. You know. There's a tower coming up from Sinfinite. Not sure exactly what that's meant for, except to just kind of counteract this tower. So you play too far in this way, you're getting more damage done or dealt, and vice versa. But there is this upgrade right here, which is very powerful against human, the fortified armor. Very powerful. If every orc got that, no one can beat him. Well, you can beat him, obviously, skill. But in this point of the game, that right there is pretty damn powerful, I have to say. I mean, as somebody who goes up against that very often, I know how pissed off I get off just that. Okay, so the Water Elemental scouts the expansion for Grubby, of course trying to take down this tower, and does go down. One burrow, of course, fortified armor. Look how little amount of damage he's doing against this burrow. I mean, that's like nothing compared to without fortified armor. Of course, with all this army here and Grubby not... Actually, Grubby's going after the expansion of Sinfinite here, so it might be an even trade. Of course, trying to coerce a town portal from either of them. I believe whoever town portals is in a worse shape here. Still, my lightning shielding and killing a bunch of peasants. The orc tiny great hall is still up. He's just keeping his summons there, and I believe he's going back to Grubby's base, while Sinfinite's expansion is getting ruined as well. Neither of the players are mining at the moment. Human does pick up a TP, which is very strange here because... Okay, I wasn't sure if the... Okay, not the whole army was able to get teleported in this scenario, but definitely had enough units to teleport to shove Grubby out of his expansion. Alright. So he's going to try to take down this unit here, get more experience. Of course, if he gets 5-5 on his heroes, that's a big game changer. I mean, that's something that you can't really fight. 5-5, if you don't have any resources or anything. Of course, Sinfinite continually sending summons over here to the expansion of the orc. Orc not able to do anything about it until it's gone. Now it might try to get a tower, maybe even another burrow. Try to keep his units safe and keep it healed up. He's not building any peasants. He doesn't have any gold. He only has 10 gold. So I'm very confused on what Grubby should do here. He's got to sell some items, I believe. Maybe sell his town portal, and that's going to be devastating. Shaman here, not taking down that water elemental with the purge. Letting these summons just keep coming to his base, and I think that's not the right idea. There is a Tauren out. Tauren, a unit here that's very powerful, but one alone doesn't make a game. I mean, there's way too many spellbreakers, more slow. I mean, there's only two sorceresses here, but of course if he's continually mining, which he's not because of the summons of Grubby, this is just turned into, hey, if I'm not going to mine, you're not going to mine either. But Grubby seems to need his peons that much more, so he's making sure his workers are not dead. One peasant here for the human. One peasant. If Grubby just went over here and destroyed that expansion, he wins. Not necessarily, but you get the gist. Of course he's getting blocked right here. He's getting wrecked a little bit. He's losing more units. But he has to forcefully teleport out. And I'm sure he's going to go straight for this now. Because if he takes that down, and he has Sinfinite has no workers. I believe he has 1-2 workers. That's GG. I would imagine. But Grubby doesn't have much gold, and Sinfinite only has enough for another worker, which I'm surprised he's not using. He could sell that Ring of Protection. It's not useful at this point. Shaman still doing a bunch of purges. A lot more experience going on that Fire Lord. Oh, almost got another purge off. Level 8 on the Fire Lord, almost 9. Slowing down the Shaman here. Purges himself to get away, but is it enough? It is not. This catapult has been around for quite a long time, just continually doing damage. And I'm surprised because usually this is the unit you want to focus. Go over there, slow it, and destroy it. I believe you can slow this unit, right? Just had a dumbfounded moment. Of course, there's action going on here, but as you can see, the human's still not mining. The orc is still here and mining, for the most part. So that's a big plus for Grubby, while Sinfinite is over here trying to do as much damage as possible, and he's actually starting to lose a lot of his units. Grubby lost a bunch of his units, but he's still sort of mining, it looks like. Lava spawn, not doing anything. Trying to go after units, but it's not really working. Level 9 on the Fire Lord. Level 9, is he getting another Tauren up? He doesn't have the resources at the moment. He has 4 peons in Burrow, but he can't really do anything with that water elemental, just continually doing damage. Of course, the Archmage is going to win this war every time because of Brilliance Aura. He can just continually send out not only his spawns, but also the spawns from the Fire Lord on his side. This will give level 5 on the human heroes. Level 5 on both human heroes. This is where it gets tricky. I don't think Grubby can hold off. I don't believe a few purges is going to take down level 3 water elementals and level 3 lava spawns. Not to mention when they're being sent here now, doing even more damage. This is where it gets really tricky. And especially when Grubby's continually losing more and more units. Nice pulverize. That pulverize is perhaps winning him the game. He definitely wants to, Sinfinite definitely wants to take down that Tauren. And does so. It would take way too long to train up witch doctors, get him master training to heal this back up to existence. So that's out of the possibilities. Is he going to train up another Tauren? He has the resource for it. Now he definitely needs this here. A full mana shaman to purge all the elementals and the lava spawns that come to his base. He's taking down more and more units. Look at this. He's continually taking down more units, and he's still sending lava spawns with speed scrolls into the expansion of Sinfinite. Quite impressive. More purges can happen here any second now. Another purge. Almost level 10 Fire Lord. Grubby is still mining. Sinfinite obviously is not. There's still 2 workers here. I'm not sure exactly what he's trying to do with those 2 workers continually getting lumber. Another lava spawn goes down from Sinfinite, but this burrow looks like it's going to go down. And with that burrow going down, that's much less defenses. That Fire Lord is in a little bit of danger, but of course he is mining. He is going to get healing potions, and that's what he just picks up. Spellbreaker is doing a lot of damage, taking out all the mana from this Fire Lord. But that Fire Lord is wearing him down and taking him out. Look at the amount of units here from Sinfinite now. Sinfinite down to a few breakers and a priest. Lava Spawn, 56 damage just duplicates. That's rough. But another Spellbreaker goes down. Fire Lord from Grubby is now repositioning himself, throwing himself over here. Are we going to see a level 10 Fire Lord, or is this over? What's taking damage right now? This Spellbreaker is taking a lot of damage right here. Lava Spawn is doing a lot of damage. Water Elemental is doing a lot of damage. Another Purge comes in. So close. I think one more Purge, level 3 summon, and I believe Grubby will have level 10. Not close to level 6 on the human heroes, but the Archmage is rather low. Gets purged by the Shaman. Gets soul burned and purged again. Could not move. Level 10 on the Fire Lord from Grubby. Purging more summons here. I don't believe a level 5 Fire Lord can beat a level 10 Fire Lord. I believe that is close to impossible. Takes down another unit there. There's not going to be any more water elementals unless he starts to mine here. He's sending one peasant over here to mine. See what his gold issue is here. Yep, so he is not getting any gold, and he's not going to be able to afford another worker. And that's the GG. Takes down the Fire Lord here. And it looks like he was bloodlusted. Wow. That was an incredible comeback from Grubby, I gotta say. Well, if you enjoyed that, give me a like, man. Check out my channel if you're new. And, yeah, stay cool, man, because that was a cool game.